Welcome back. It's day four of the Essential Oil Experience. Thank you for listening to the videos up until now. I hope you've enjoyed them. If you have any questions, please write them down. You can get a hold of me at any time to go over those, or maybe when these are all done, we can sit down and chat about some of the questions you have. There are an awful lot of uses for essential oils, including the one that we are going to be talking about today called frankincense. Frankincense is a very well-known oil, but you may not have ever wondered or even thought about how to use it other than perhaps in worship. Everyone knows that this particular oil, or perhaps the resin, but a version of frankincense was presented to Christ. Now, I said to you resin, and that may confuse you a little bit. What's a resin? Well, frankincense is one of the essential oils that is made from a tree resin. Oils like lavender are from a flower. Lemon is from the lemon. It's from the rind of the lemon. Peppermint is from the herb plant. Frankincense is from a tree, and this particular one is from the resin, the frankincense resin that is extracted from a tree. When they tap the tree to get the resin out of it, it's an amazing process, but it has to be done on trees that are a certain age. We do have a frankincense farm, and it is in the Middle East. It's amazing, you guys. So when they tap to the frankincense tree to get the resin, the tree does have to be a certain age, and they extract it. And what happens is that the resin residue, will seal the hole in the trunk. So it will preserve the tree so it can make more resin. That's if the oil is extracted properly. There are some frankincenses in the world that are not extracted properly. Actually, you know what? There are all kinds of frankincenses out there. There are thousands of varieties, but there are only four that are known to have an effect on the human body. Most people don't know that. In fact, most resellers probably know that but don't care. You can get a very, very inexpensive frankincense for almost nothing, but it's not going to be like what's in this bottle. This one is an absolute treasure. It's one of the reasons our kits are so valuable. A properly extracted frankincense of this strain, by the way, I'll give you a little Latin here. This strain is called Boswellia carteri. A properly extracted resin of this strain is difficult to source, and therefore it makes it a high value oil. So this is an amazing oil, and this one does have a great effect on the human body. We do have other versions of frankincense as well, but this is our most popular and our best seller, and it's in the premium starter kit. When you smell it, a lot of frankincenses do smell the same, so people can be very easily fooled. But when you smell it, it will perhaps remind you of church. If you've ever been in a church that has had frankincense resin around, there's a reason for that. It is a very good emotional and spiritual oil. It will help you be centered spiritually. It can be used in prayer very effectively. It has an immediate impact on the brain. This is such a fantastic oil. But there are some exceptional uses outside of that. This one is in our dual labeling, so it'll be the white label, the Vitality ones that I showed you in some of the other videos. It'll have a white and red label. That's the one that the FDA says that we can tell you can ingest. And this is the solid label that's labeled for topical and aromatic use. Remember, same oil, just different labeling so people can understand how to use them. I'm going to be talking about all of the uses, however. Frankincense can be ingested. It's very, very good for your immune system. I like to sing. I sing with my worship team at my church, so a lot of times I will just knock this one back. It really helps my throat just feel a lot better. If there's any swelling in there, it really helps calm that down. This oil is also fantastic for your skin. It has a bit of an anti-aging effect to it. It's good for any type of skin irritations. This oil is wonderful. There are so many uses for frankincense. I can't even really get into them all. But one little thing that you might find interesting, if you Google snake oils, that's probably a term you're familiar with. If you Google it, two different types of essential oils will come up. One is tea tree and the other is frankincense. There's a reason for that. Those two oils were one of the first two essential oils that were used for wound care. Remember, the frankincense can heal the resin of a tree. Well, it can also heal your skin. So frankincense was one of the original oils that were selected if you had an injury from a snake. But the irreputable people in that time were putting the fake stuff in the bottles and selling it for a lot of money. So that's a little tip for you today on frankincense. Another use that I love for frankincense is just right on the top of my head, kind of like I showed you with peppermint. It gets right into the limbic center of the brain very quickly, and it can really help you feel very emotionally balanced and centered. Okay. Again, lots and lots of uses for frankincense. Those are just some of them. I'm going to close by showing you that little towel back there. I think it says I have an oil for that. That's sort of a famous saying with us oilers. We will often say, I've got an oil for that. Well, you're starting to see why, right? Many, many uses for essential oils. That's it for today. Tune in tomorrow and we'll talk about another oil.